Hello and welcome to livealittlehigher.com. Today we continue learning from our book, The Mystery of Marriage by Rabbi Itzhak Ginsberg, and we're in chapter 11. And the theme today is called The Female Pulse of Time, Run and Return. So as we remember last week, we were speaking about how women have their own essence in time, like they're not 24/7. They have a time on and a time off due to their cycle, and they're like the moon, like they have phases in the month. This week we will be talking about a Kabbalistic concept which is called run and return, ratzov eshov, which means that a person has such spiritual desires that to connect to Hashem that he can really connect in such a way that he can lose his life. It's more the Lubavitcher Rebbe, every time he used to give a discourse, he used to grab himself from a napkin, and he would hold onto that napkin because he became so elevated and connected to God when he was giving the discourse that he could have disconnected himself from this world, and God forbid, he could have died. But he grabbed onto this napkin so he would remember that he was in an earthly abode and that he had to return to this world to be able to fulfill the purpose for which he was created. So the same way here, it's telling us that there's a difference in nature of man than from woman, and the dynamics in the relationship of a husband and a wife are also different. Men and women are not the same. Women are very different than men in every way, the way they think, the way they feel, the way they behave. And men think, feel, and behave in different ways too. So typically a wife gives of herself in marital relationships more openly and completely than a husband. The wife is much more loving usually than the husband, and she's more giving to the husband than the husband is to her. Because women usually are very selfless human beings. They have this instinct, this motherly nature of taking care of everybody. And the last person they think about is themselves. So this is so because the wife's tendency towards total involvement reflects her inner dynamic of run and return. The phrase run and return, ratzov eshov, appears in the vision of Ezekiel, in which he references to the angels of the divine chariot, where he says, and the angels were running and returning as the vision of a bolt of fire. The words used here for angels, hayot, it means literally living beings, and in Kabbalah and Hasidut, this term is taken to refer to the underlying pulse of a life, hayot, which alternately runs upward. So the soul is usually trying to connect up. And I've said it in other classes, in which if you take a candle and you turn it upside down, you'll see how the flame is always striving to go higher. It will never go down. It will always try to go higher. So this runs upward is a need to reunite with the divine, with Hashem, and thereafter it returns downward, investing itself with new life force. So we all need some time to inspire ourselves, to find things that will connect us to Hashem, that will aspire us to go to a higher level. And especially in this month of Elul, which is really a month in which we are striving to connect to God, God is in the field, the King is in the field, it's easier for us to connect to Hashem. Once we come out from this high, from the month of Elul and the month of Tishrei, when you live a life in which you're connecting to all these holidays and you like go into this cocoon of sanctity, once the holidays are over, the next week it's like you come down and you're deflated. Like, what happened to me? I was in such a high, and now I have to come back to the real world. That's what happens. So in aspiring to total union with her beloved, a wife expresses the natural, albeit not generally conscious, it's in a subconscious level, tendency of the soul as the bride of the Song of Songs, Shira Shirim, and indeed of all creation, to run towards her beloved. And the beloved is Hashem. and extricate itself from the alienation imposed upon it by the prison of the body. So the soul is always trying, the soul is the bride, is the woman. It's always trying to connect back to her source. And then she realizes that she has to come back to this world to be able to fulfill the purpose for which she was created. And this run of the soul is unmitigated by a corresponding return and may have unhealthy consequences. For example, in the famous Talmudic story of the four sages that enter paradise and what happened to them. So we read how Ben Asai died, Ben Soma went insane, Elisha ben Avuya renounced to his faith, and only Rabbi Akiva was able to come back in peace. He entered in peace and he emerged in peace. So let's understand what happened here. Hasidut teaches that Rabbi Akiva survived because he set out on his mystical journey with the intention and the commitment to surrender to the divine will. So his only intention was to do what Hashem wanted from him. But when we are trying to connect to God because we have our own selfish interests, that's what's happened. People go crazy, people get away from religion, because it's a selfish thing. It's about them and it's not about God. And this included a commitment to return to a lower realm after having reached the height of his soul ascending to cling to God. The basis of this commitment is the allegiance to the divine purpose of creation. So when we understand that we have an energy in this world, everything is created with this energy, Ratzo Veshov, the run and return. If you look at the world, how it's run, like if you look at the ocean, the waves go in and they come out. They go in and they come out. The tide goes up and it comes down. The day becomes day and the night becomes night. When a person breathes, the lungs fill with air and then they lose the air. They fill with air and they lose the air. The heart pumps in and out, pumps in and out. And this is the energy, this is the symphony of life. But when we only go one way and we don't come back, then that's when we cease to exist. So, in this world. So, here we are reminded by the story in the Torah of Nadab and Abihu, who were the sons of Aaron HaKohen. And if we remember, they offered volunteer incense on the day of the inauguration of the tabernacle of the Mishkan in the desert. And they went into the Holy of Holies without asking permission, and they gave this incense, this fire, and their souls, it just came out of their bodies and they perished. They went up to heaven to God and they were burned. So the question here is, what happened to them? If a person is so much in love with Hashem, why is it not good in this way? So from them we learn that yes, we have to have this love for God. We have to want to be close to Him. We need to work ourselves to be closer to Hashem every time, and even more and more and more. But we have to understand that the best way to be close to God is in this world. So we go and take the run, we go ratzo, we get close to Hashem to get the strength and the inspiration that we need to be able to do veshov, to return to this world, to do Torah and mitzvahs. And in this way, we're doing it like Rabbi Akiva did, which was out of a selfless love for Hashem. He did it for him. He didn't do it for himself. And the wife, in this case, really, this is what a woman should live like, because sometimes women, they give so much, and they forget about themselves that they burn out. And suddenly everything becomes heavy, and everything becomes a core, and suddenly they feel abused, and they feel neglected, and they feel they are not loved. And the woman needs to take care of herself too. So the ratzo veshov of a woman is really, she needs that inspiration, she needs to connect to God, she needs to be always striving to be more connected, but at the same time, that connection to God, that strength, that emunah and bitachon, that her relationship to God gives her, in reality is for her to come back to this world, to come back to her home, to come back to her husband, to her children, and give them what she needs to give them with love. And understand that that's her purpose in life, that her purpose is to take care of her family. But she also needs to give herself that boost and that inspiration and that ratzo veshov and take care of herself. So I wish that you have a good week, a beautiful week, a healthy, full of shalom bite, and live a little higher. Thank you.